I don't know who you are. I don't know what you want. If you are looking for ransom, I can tell you I don't have money. But what I do have are a very particular set of skills. Skills I have acquired over a very long career. Skills that make me a nightmare for people like you.
The Commuter, directed by Jaume Collet-Serra, is the latest Liam Neeson action thriller which, funnily enough, shares similarities to Neeson's breakout old man action romp, 2008's Taken, in that Neeson's character Michael Woolrich is the only one who can track down an individual due to his very particular set of skills. But this time it's on a train, as a mysterious and beautiful woman, played by Vera Farmiga, approaches a newly unemployed and financially strapped Michael with a proposition. Find the person on the train that goes by the name of Prin before they get off, and receive $100,000 in cash. But of course, things go off the rails. To Collet-Serra's credit, I'll say that he certainly knows how to get a lot out of one location, as he utilizes pretty much every aspect of the train throughout the course of the film, even the underneath. And I appreciate that while this is a January-released action film, they didn't have Neeson doing a fight scene on top of the train trying to dodge tunnels. In fact, the action scenes were actually pretty compelling, with Neeson proving once again how much of a badass he is, with most of his action scenes shot in unbroken, wide takes, even when he's thrown around. For a 65-year-old to do that, you can color me impressed. I also admired that Neeson's character wasn't an idiot, using practical methods of making a seemingly impossible task slightly more possible, like switching off the air conditioning and herding the passengers into a single car. But I am left to wonder if the American public transport system uses some sort of MetroCard go-kart system, or if they still use punch-hole tickets. But aside from that, The Commuter is unfortunately a paint-by-numbers action thriller, very much in the vein of Collet-Serra and Neeson's previous 2014 outing, Non-Stop. The plot is somewhat lackluster, with key dramatic elements either being left unexplained or summed up in a single line of dialogue before a gun is fired or a punch is thrown. Much of its personal dramatic tension is traded for an overblown and ridiculous third-act action scene as well. And while I will say that the initial premise is engaging, if you're any kind of savvy moviegoer, you can probably call the film's third act twist, which is unfortunate. But this film comes out in January, so is anyone really surprised?